Dear students, good morning. Welcome to Prelims Program 2019 by Law Excellence. So the first in the series, we are releasing NDA Yearbook and Schemes and Programs. The objective here is to cover entire NDA Yearbook only from the prelims perspective. NDA Yearbook can provide you ample information for both prelims, mains and interview. Here, we try to understand objective of a scheme and how is it being financed, who are the beneficiaries, like these details, and also various institutions of government of India under various ministries, various public sector undertakings, developmental institutions, executing agencies, everything we are going to see as part of this particular series. We will try to complete this series in a week, at max 10 days. Watch them and read the material. We will also try to give you ready reckoner on India Yearbook schemes and programs and the institutions. So, the first project or first ministry which we are going to cover is Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas as part of energy. What are the various schemes of this ministry? The first one is Pradhan Mantri Ujjwala Yojana. So what is the objective of this scheme? That is LPG for every household. It means that is every household is eligible for LPG connection or subsidized cylinders, what exactly it is. Under this scheme, LPG connections are being provided, not the LPG cylinders. Every month, whatever the cylinder which a person gets, it is subsidized and benefits are transferred under PEHEL scheme. But to get LPG connection at the first instance, the scheme which was there is Ujjwala Yojana. So as for this, who are eligible? Only the BPL households, that is below poverty line households. And then on what basis the BPL will be determined? It is socio-economic caste census. As per this scheme, any BPL household who is going to get a new LPG connection is provided with a financial support of 1600 rupees. So if a question comes this way, what are the benefits of Pradhan Mantri Ujjwala Yojana? Remember, clean fuel is better fuel. In India, because of the use of the regular cooking methods, there is a lot of indoor pollution, air pollution. So this clean fuel is meant to protect the health of women. And the second thing, respiratory illnesses, all these comes under the health of the woman. And it is also meant to provide for empowerment of the woman, as the time meant to collect the wood, etc. is being saved. Women can spend the time for productive purposes. And there is another aspect. As rural youth are being provided with an opportunity to maintain the logistics with regard to the distribution of these gas cylinders, etc., rural youth employment can also be achieved. So this appears as out of the mark. But remember, employment to rural youth is also part of this particular program. So let's revise. LPG connections to the BPL families. An initial is 1600 rupees. What is the small criticism of this program? Now, the first connection is being subsidized. Then what about the cylinders? So there is no specific subsidy available on the cylinders. So in that case, people may not effectively use the LPG cylinders. From prelims perspective, the subsidy is not on LPG cylinders for these people. And the next is PEHEL scheme. So what is this PEHEL scheme is about? Remember, cash transfers in India, we call it as direct benefits transfer. So this direct benefit transfers to LPG subsidy. This is what we call it as PEHEL scheme. As per this, LPG cylinders are supplied at the market price to the customer, and the customers will receive the subsidy directly into their bank accounts. So a customer will buy the LPG cylinder, and if he or she is eligible for subsidy, government transfers that to their account. On what basis? The bank account of the customer is linked with the Aadhaar card. So it's an Aadhaar enabled payment system. So in this context, if Aadhaar is not there, is subsidy denied to them? No. So government, through various advertisements related to food security and also LPG cylinders, clearly stated that if Aadhaar is not available, they can produce other identity to get this particular benefit. The next is LPG Panchayat. Pradhan Mantri LPG Panchayat. So this clearly says the beginning of a positive change. So here the government want to encourage non-LPG cylinder users to shift towards the LPG cylinders, which is stated to be a clean fuel. So there are many behavioral changes are necessary. So recently in Hindu articles, we saw a few things. The people, especially in the northern belt, they think that the food which is cooked on gas stove is going to cause certain stomach problems and it will not be tasty. And also it adds up to certain diseases like loss of hunger, etc. So these particular perceptions have to be changed. So generating the awareness and making the people to use clean fuel, thereby achieve safety, health, better environment, economic empowerment and development, that is what is the objective. So Panchayat is about awareness generation. Next, we have Saksham 2018. So what is this program? So it is launched by PCRA. What is this PCRA stands for? Petroleum Conservation Research Association. What this organization does? Conservation of the fuel. So in this case, it is also an awareness program. So objective is different. Conserve fuel, save future. So it is efficient use of the fuel and conservation of the petroleum products. That is what is the objective over here. And Startup Sangam scheme. So this is first of its kind launched by oil and gas industry. So it is meant to encourage technology and startup skills and environment in oil and gas industry. So under this, what they are doing, 30 startups will be encouraged with 320 crore of rupees over 3 years. So here the proof of concept has to be submitted and these P companies will get the financial support from the oil and natural gas public sector undertakings. Pradhan Mantri Urja Ganga. So this is a gas pipeline that runs from Jagadishpur to Haldia and then Bokaro Dhamra. So this is called JHBD gas pipeline, natural gas pipeline. It is part of National Gas Grid Project, which is developed by Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas. So what is the total length of this project? It is 3,376 kilometers. This major leg is 2,655 kilometers. So how many states are going to be benefited? 6 states. What are they? UP, Bihar, Jharkhand, West Bengal, Odisha, Assam. So northeastern states, northeastern leg, it is not yet extended, but the government is planning to extend it further. On this line, 3 fertilizer units are going to be revived. One is Gorakhpur, Barauni and Sindri. These 3 fertilizer units will be revived across this gas pipeline. Obviously, industrial development and also clean gas supply to the households across these 70 districts will be done through this particular program. The next is Ministry of Power. So electricity, if you take, first is generation, after that transmission, distribution, and then it has to go to the end user. So at the level of generation, what are the various sources? So we have traditional sources, majorly thermal, hydro, nuclear, and also we have renewables. So when we come to the end user, what do we have? At the level of the end user, access is important. It means the power supply and power connection shall exist. And then quality and reliability has to exist. The quality power shall be available 24 into 7 to the need of the individual. And in this context, electrification is very much important. So obviously at the distribution level, we have distribution companies which are called as DISCOMs. And these DISCOMs has to purchase the power from the producers, and then these have to be supplied to the end users. So for the transmission lines have to be laid, and national grid has to be developed. So in the generation level, today the public sector is not alone participating. There are independent power producers. So from this independent power producers, it has to be bought by the DISCOMs. What are the various schemes here? At the end user level, at the rural level, we have Deenadayal Upadhyay Gram Jyoti Yojana. And for the urban level, to improve the transmission and quality of the power, we have integrated power development scheme. So the next is to improve at the end user level, improvement of the efficiency of the power is also important. So in this case, we have a scheme that is called Ujala scheme, Unnata Jyoti by affordable LED scheme. So it is to fix LED and give the LEDs at 40% subsidized rate at the market level. And also World Bank is supporting energy efficiency program in India, that is India Energy Efficiency Scale Up Program. At the DISCOMs level, you know there is a popular scheme launched long back, that is UDAY, that stands for Ujjwala DISCOM Assurance Yojana. And then Power Ministry under Mr. Piyush Goyal has developed more transparent applications, apps for the consumer use. That can be a beautiful question, such as Garv app, next is Urja Mitra app, Merit app, like these different applications, mobile applications are developed. These e-governance initiatives in Ministry of Power can be a question to us. Now let us start and see the schemes. First is Deenadayal Upadhyaya Gram Jyoti Yojana. So obviously this is the flagship scheme for rural power supply. So they want to give 24/7 power supply to the rural areas. So what is the major problem over here? One is leakages. And the second is, at the agriculture level, non-supply of the power is the major reason for drying of the crops. So quality power has to be supplied to the agriculture. So in this case, they provide for separation of feeders. It means agricultural use, there will be separate transformers. Household use, there will be separate transformers. And to prevent the leakages, there will be metering at every level. So at the transformer level, feeder level, every level, they will create a separate meter. And they try to estimate for how much is the power used for the fields, how much power is used for the households. And the second, electricity given for agriculture is subsidized by most of the states. The separation of the feeders also helps us for not misusing the power given for the agriculture for other consumptive purposes. So the 24/7 power supply, reliable transmission lines, separation of the feeders, metering at all levels, these are the objectives of Deenadayal Upadhyay Gram Jyoti Yojana. And as part of this, there is another program that is called Remote Village Electrification Program. So this is also called last mile connectivity of the electricity. So in this case, the renewable energy, that like solar energy, etc., has to be used. So this solar energy is meant to provide for last mile connectivity. Obviously, it is not under the Ministry of Power. It is Ministry of Renewable Energy. Next is IPDS scheme. It is Integrated Power Development Scheme. So this scheme is meant for the urban areas. So it aims to develop distribution network for the urban areas. So if you see, the advertisement here says 40,000 distribution transformers installed. So it is actually the center finances this scheme for the 24/7 supply in the urban areas. So Integrated Power Development Scheme, smart sub-transmission, better distribution, energized action. This clearly shows that it is meant to create infrastructure meant for strengthening of power distribution in urban areas. That is what we call it as power sub, that is IPDS. What is the app to monitor this? That is called Urja app. Toll free number is 1912. National LED program. So LEDs are energy efficient. So there is a public sector entity called Energy Efficiency Services Limited, EESL. So this EESL implements this program. As per this, the LED bulbs will be given for 40% cheaper rate compared to the market price to the households. And the second, there is also a street light program under this. The street light program is to replace existing street lights through the LED bulbs. So these are meant to create energy efficiency systems. India Energy Efficiency Scale-Up Program. So this is a $300 million program which is financed by the World Bank. So the objective is to provide for, encourage the people to use LED bulbs and also energy efficient fans and other equipment, electricity equipment. And again, see here, 170 million tons of reduced carbon dioxide emission. So we want to shift towards the cleaner energy and reduce the carbon dioxide emissions which are generated during the production of this power, especially through thermal power. So at the user level, efficient use of the power is the objective. So by decreasing the CO2 emissions, we are meant to get the carbon credits, and we are able to meet the targets which are there under the Paris Agreement. Who is implementing this? This is again Energy Efficiency Services Limited, a public sector undertaking under the government of. Next is VUDAI. So VUDAI stands for Ujjwal DISCOM Assurance Yojana. The major problem with the DISCOMs in India is this. The state governments start populistic programs like free power to the farmers. So obviously these DISCOMs have to bear this burden. Many a times state governments do not provide the money necessary for DISCOMs on time. So DISCOMs, they are unable to buy the power and sell it to the customer. At the customer level, power is necessary and there is surplus power at the producer level. But the mediator who has to buy and transfer the power to the customer, he do not have the sufficient money to provide the services. In this context, revamping the DISCOMs, that is what is the objective of the Ujjwal DISCOM Assurance Yojana. So in this case, what is the objective over here? Quarterly tariff increase, operational efficiency, lower cost of power. So it means, remember here, first, whatever the debt the DISCOMs have, 75% will be taken over by the state governments. And obviously, what will be the concern of the state government? Will it raise my fiscal deficit? If the fiscal indiscipline is projected, they will not get the necessary finances from the center. So that's why whatever the money or burden which is given to the state governments from the DISCOMs, it will not be counted as part of the fiscal discipline, that is fiscal deficit. And the state governments will issue bonds for this purpose. State development bonds can be issued for this purpose. And the remaining 25%, the DISCOMs has to bear that burden, and the banks will consider that as a loan or bond, and then the financial thing will be restored. So in this case, the major challenge is ensuring the debt restructuring and implementing it properly. So the objective of the DISCOM Assurance Yojana is to make the DISCOMs viable. So in this case, the power leakages also have to be reduced. So lower cost of the power is also the objective. And how we will get the low cost of the power? By increasing the operational efficiency. So this is the next is Urja Mitra. This is a mobile application and a web platform. Read what it says over here. Power outage information at your doorsteps. So whenever you lose power and when you are going to have a power cut, everything will be given to you at the in the mobile application. So this is available for both urban and rural power consumers. Merit portal. The merit here stands for merit order dispatch of electricity for rejuvenation of income and transparency. So in this, all the information state-wise will be available. We will see how much is the power produced, how much is being dispatched, what is the power deficit, and which states are in deficit, from where, from which source they can buy. So in that way, the prices are transparent, and at the same time, the producers and how much surplus they are producing, everything is visible for the customers and also buyers and the sellers. So it is a transparency initiative. And then, Pradhan Mantri Sahaj Bijli Har Ghar Yojana, it is also called Saubhagya. So what is this meant for? It is electrification of the entire village. So every household in the village who is interested to have the power, they shall get access to it. So in this context, electrification of the households in the village is been brought under the scheme, that is Saubhagya. So every village which is 100% electrified will be declared as a Saubhagya village. That is what is the essence of this. And then, Eco Nivas. So what is this? Eco means energy conservation. Nivas means house. New Indian way of affordable and sustainable homes. So what is this? This is also a mobile application. So in your computer, if you try to give your plan of the house and what are the modifications that can be made to ensure the energy conservation, that is given through this particular website. Then who is running this? Who developed this? Bureau of Energy Efficiency. So Bureau of Energy Efficiency, it is a statutory body. The next is National Power Portal. What is this about? So we have seen different apps now. So what are the apps we saw? One is Merit app, Eco Nivas, and then we have Urja app. For all these apps, one single dashboard is available. This is what is called National Power Portal, which is managed by the Central Electricity Authority. And then, what are the various apps by the Ministry of Power? One is Tarang. Tarang is transmission app for real-time monitoring. It means at various levels, how much is the power is getting transmitted at a particular point of time. That can be checked under Tarang. Ujala. Ujala app is to monitor the LED installation across the country. Vidyut Pravaha. Power demand, surplus power, and then power exchange. Prices at various level, everything are being given under this. And then GARV, village electrification is been monitored through GARV. Any person who is, all the villages which are electrified under the Saubhagya scheme and Deenadayal Gram Jyoti Yojana, everything will be placed in this particular app. And anyone finds a mistake in reporting, they can inform it to the ministry concerned through the app. And then Urja scheme. This is Urban Jyoti Abhiyan. It is to monitor IPDS scheme. Already we saw this. And then Merit. It is a e-bidding portal for the states, power deficit states, to buy the power from the independent power producers and power surplus states. So these are the important applications. There can be a question in this particular area. The next ministry is Ministry of New and Renewable Energy. So here, various schemes that are exist. One is KUSUM. So this KUSUM, it is for farmers. K here stands for Kisan. Kisan Urja Suraksha Evam Uttan Amaha Abhiyan. That is what is KUSUM is. Just remember, K is for Kisan. So this is renewable energy support to the farmers. And then we have Surya Mitra scheme. So Surya Mitra scheme is meant to create technicians who can install solar panels and photovoltaic cells. And then the targets to install the solar panels, it is under the Solar Jawaharlal Nehru National Solar Mission. And then we have solar cities. So this is local governments and government of India work together to improve the renewable energy. So renewable energy is a clean energy. Let us see the KUSUM program. So in the KUSUM program, there is a decentralized production of electricity. It means farmers are encouraged to produce electricity from their farms itself. There are two major components. One is irrigation pumps And if you see here, there is a clear irrigation pump in this advertisement. And the second is solar panels installed on a field, on a barren land. So non-cultivated land, if it is there, they can create solar panels over there and earn up to 60,000 rupees per annum through this, per acre. And then solar pumps. Today, the farmers are dependent on the power which is coming from the grid. So obviously, this power is not qualitative, that is erratic. So the solar pumps can run on the solar power and the subsidy will be provided for the farmers onto this. So again, if you see DISCOMs, most of the DISCOMs are in losses because their power is being subsidized to the agriculture. So as agricultural electricity is produced in the farm field itself, obviously there is no necessity of the power from the DISCOMs. And then what are the total advantages of this? As it is a decentralized power production and excess power is being connected to the grid, there are two important advantages. The transmission losses will be almost zero. And the second, the financial health of the DISCOMs will be improved. And the third thing, income security to the farmers is expected to increase. So in this entire thing, the states are also expected to get support to meet their renewable energy targets. It means that every state has to procure certain percentage of the power from the renewable energy sources to meet Paris targets. So this program helps them to meet these particular targets. And at the end of the day, energy efficiency is increased. So these are the points. Now, the next is Surya Mitra. So this Surya Mitra is what? It is a skill development program for installation of the solar panels. So what is the objective here? To develop 50,000 trained technicians by March 2020. That is the objective. Are engineers, BTech students are eligible for this? No. Only the ITIs and also people who possess diploma in engineering are eligible to be trained as technicians. Who is enforcing this? National Institute of Solar Energy. This is what implementing this program. Jawaharlal Nehru National Solar Mission. So it is meant to generate 100 gigawatts of the power by 2022. And you know that it is part of the National Action Plan on Climate Change. And the third thing here is 40 gigawatts of the power as part of this has to come from the rooftops. 60 gigawatts of the power, it has to come from large and medium scale installations which are grid connected. So in India, we are able to move forward on the grid connected installations, but rooftop solar panels, we are very poor for this. That is the challenge over here. The next is Solar Cities Program. Under this, the local government, they will be given certain support from the central government. So the target here is to achieve at least 10% reduction of the conservative consumption of power. It means whatever the sources which we are getting the power today, among that 10% of the power has to come from solar sources. That is what is the objective. Within 5 years, this has to be achieved.